With that, let us meet the gymnasts competing at this 2023 Pan American Games in Santiago. From Panama, Hillary Heron. Celia Kuriakus, the 18-year-old. Lana Herrera, just 16. Carla Navas, the 19-year-old Panamanian all-around champion. This is Panama. They will begin on the balance beam.
Colombia!
The team of Colombia, the gold medalists at the Bolivarian Games last year and bronze at the Central American and Caribbean Games earlier this year. They have never won a Pan American Games medal, but they too are especially promising. Angelica Mesa, the 29-year-old from Sogamoso. Iseth Valenzuela. Luisa Blanco. And Daira La Madrid. They're joined by 26-year-old Gina Escobar, a member of that 2022 Bolivarian Games champion team.
States of America, Ecuador, Bolivia, Jamaica, and El Salvador.
The mixed group that will start on the uneven bars. Beginning with 17-year-old Caitlin Young. Alex Perea, the 18-year-old from Ecuador, joined by 17-year-old Ashley Bohorquez. Diana Vasquez, the 25-year-old from Santa Cruz. Tisha Matis, the 24-year-old born in London, representing Jamaica. From El Salvador, 28-year-old Alexa Grande, the balance beam silver medalist at the Bolivarian Games last year.
Mexico! Mexico!
Mexico, the gold medalist at the 2023 Central American and Caribbean Games, 14th at the World Championships earlier this month. 23-year-old Cassandra Lustalot. Natalia Escalera, the 21-year-old from Ensenada. Ashtiri Sandoval, the 27-year-old from Guadalajara. Paulina Campos, 23. And the 29-year-old star, Alexa Moreno from Mexicali, the capital of Baja California, and one of the most accomplished Mexican gymnasts in history. Mexico will begin on the vault. And there you have it, the teams of Subdivision 1, and there is going to be quite a lot to keep track of. As ever, gymnasts will get a 3-minute warm-up inside the arena to just get a feel for the equipment before competition begins in earnest.
In the first rotation,
on the uneven bars, we will start off with Caitlin Young and also take a look potentially at Tisha Matis.
On uneven bars, mixed group one, the United States.
Mexico, meanwhile, will begin on the vault, where they are very solid. Two of its gymnasts will be performing two vaults in an attempt to qualify for the apparatus finals in Natalia Escalera, as well as Atsiri Sandoval.
On balance beam, Panama.
warming up on the uneven bars. The two gymnasts from Ecuador, Ashley Bohorquez and Alias Perea. Perea won all-around silver at the Bolivarian Games last year in Colombia, and also gold on the balance beam. At just 18, she's really one potentially to keep an eye on. On uneven bars typically take a bit longer because some gymnasts like to prepare the bars their own way. And so while competition begins on the other three apparatus, it looks like Tayshia Mattis is still taking her warm up. How wonderful it is to see her back in international competition. Meanwhile, this is the warm-up of the gymnast from El Salvador, Alexa Grande, the 28-year-old. Daughter of a marathon runner. Champion at the Junior Pan American Games in 2021. She begins on uneven bars. Representing the United States, Caitlin Yong. Steady in-bar Stalder to straddle Shaposhnikova to immediate pack Salto. Impressive work with her in-bar Stalders. Many agree that those are the most difficult form of Stalder that a gymnast can do. And a double tuck with a full twist at the end. Nice beginning from Caitlin Yong of the United States. Yong is here as an individual, although still representing the USA, but she will not take part in the team competition. She is here for herself and trying to obtain a place in the all-around and perhaps individual apparatus finals later this week. Steady Jaeger. It's a nice routine to start with for her. Yong says her favorite event is the uneven bars. She seems pretty psyched by what she just did. Over to the vault and Cassandra Lustalot of Mexico. Very nice Cuervo handspring with a half twist and a back pike salto off. Waiting for her score to come in on uneven bars is Caitlin Young. And she's a very solid all-around gymnast, Caitlin Young. Currently ranked sixth in the United States and fifth on the uneven bars. Young's score is taking a while to come in. Could potentially be a problem with the scoring system. Sometimes there are technical issues, and those of you accustomed to watching gymnastics might be familiar with those delays. And the score is most certainly not a zero for Caitlin Young. But it was somewhere in the neighborhood of 13.8. It's a very good beginning for the young American. And now from Ecuador, Elias Pereira. Blind turn into her straddle Jaeger. And a double tuck dismount. Oh, doesn't she look thrilled to be making her Pan American Games debut? She's quite experienced for a gymnast who is still so young, having competed at the last three World Championships. And she was 10th in the all-around at her Pan American Championships debut. Competitor at the Junior World Championships as well in 2019. And she has been recognized for her accomplishments by the Ecuadorian Olympic Committee. Uneven bars done, Elias Pereira can focus on her other apparatus. And now from Mexico, Natalia Escalera. Should be a Yurchenko 1.5, and it is very well controlled. It's a type of solid vaulting that she's really become known for. A 21-year-old, the national champion in the all-around. Really nice entry onto the table. Gets good block and push off of it in order to execute those 1.5 twists. 11.7 the score for Elias Perea. And she's going to stand in and remove the springboard for her teammate, Ashley Bohorquez. The 17-year-old from Ecuador also making her Pan American Games debut. Nicely threw the toast alder full and transitioned to the high bar. Kachev. And full twisting double tuck dismount. Welcome to the Pan American Games, Ashley Bohorquez. There's nothing quite like the feeling of doing your first routine at a major competition. And with that, she is underway. Transition from high to low, known colloquially as a bail, something we don't see a lot in international competition these days. Many of the gymnasts favor pack salto type transitions. This was one of the highlights of the routine, the full twisting double tuck dismount. She finishes above the high bar in the twist and is able to set herself up for a good landing. And now we have a look at Atziri Sandoval of Mexico. What a wonderful Sukahara with a double twist. That is stellar work from Sandoval. It's one of the most difficult vaults currently being competed on the international circuit. Gymnast has to get such good block in order to complete the double twist, and she makes it easily. And also manages to keep from having a tenth of a point penalty for her foot going over the white line. The line is in gymnastics. Ashley Bohorquez, just 17 years old, from Guayaquil. And her score, 11.766. And now from Bolivia, Diana Vasquez, the 25-year-old from Santa Cruz in her 21st year of doing gymnastics. Yeah. A fairly simple routine capped with just a layout flyaway dismount. She has got her first exercise under her belt. Vasquez has appeared at two world championships and at the Pan American Championships in 2018. She was in the top 40 in the all-around competition. She had some problems with this transition up to high bar. She actually catches in what's called a dead hang and has to really muscle the kip afterwards. But she gets back into the rhythm and does her giants into this layout flyaway dismount. A basic skill, but well performed. What a road this gymnast has traveled to the Pan American Games. Tayshia Mattis, 24 years old, born in London, raised in Great Britain, and now competing for Jamaica. We'll come back to that in just a moment. 9.466, the number for Diana Vasquez of Bolivia on uneven bars. She is hugely accomplished, and she opens a new chapter of her career at the Pan American Games. Tayshia Mattis of Jamaica. Regular Shaposhnikova to immediate pack salto. Shaposhnikova with a half twist. And clear hip full to what amplitude on her Kachev. Well, well. And double front dismount. Tayshia Mattis has one routine done. She was 14th in the all-around at the Pan American Championships last year. The junior British champion in 2013, the English champion in 2014, and the first British woman to compete a double twisting, double tuck on floor exercise. And all of those accomplishments came 10 years ago. And then she disappeared for a while. There were injury problems, but she has resurfaced, and it is a new era for Tayshia Mattis. How wonderful to see her competing here. How wonderful to see her competing and thriving again.
Hello, guys.
Vaulting now for Mexico, Paulina Campos. This is the Yurchenko style with round off onto the springboard, backhand spring onto the table. She pushes off into just a simple layout somersault off. So it's not the difficulty vault that she was planning. Score for Tayshia Mattis, 12.0. Next on the uneven bars from El Salvador, here is Alexa Grande. It's a well-flighted Jaeger to open. And she too opts for the bail transition. And much the same problem we saw from Diana Vasquez. Her toe shoot to high results in a dead hang. So she'll take a deduction for that, but steady double tuck dismount. Alexa Grande says that she was fascinated by watching gymnasts perform on TV when she was a child. And she actually relocated to Guatemala from El Salvador to train because she found that the training facilities were better there. She's been to two world championships, first one in 2011 and the second one in 2019. One thing to note on her double tuck is how she keeps her knees together throughout both saltos. That's really good technique. Mm-hmm. Alexa Grande says it means a lot for her to be an elite gymnast. Her mother was a marathon runner, but she had to stop due to being injured in a car accident. And Alexa feels that she is really able to carry on what her mother started with her gymnastics career.
Gymnasts, please proceed now to your second apparatus. Y con esto concluye la primera rotación.
10.8 for Alexa Grande of El Salvador on the uneven bars. And with that, the first rotation of Subdivision 1 is complete. Here is an update of the standings. That graphic is not correct, but I can tell you that Mexico is the current leader with 39.765 points gleaned on the vault. Colombia currently in second place, 35.466, their score on floor exercise as a team. And Panama is third, having accumulated 33.666 on the balance beam. Rotation two coming up. The mixed group will move to the balance beam. Mexico goes to uneven bars. Panama will be on floor exercise, and Colombia heads over to vault.
Gymnast, your warm-up begins now. Damos inicio al tiempo de calentamiento. In this rotation, starting on vault, Colombia. En esta rotación, en salto, Colombia. On uneven bars, Mexico. En barras asimétricas, México. On balance beam, mixed group one, Ecuador, Bolivia, Jamaica, El Salvador. En viga, grupo mixto, uno, Ecuador, Bolivia, Jamaica, y El Salvador. And on floor exercise, Panama. Y el suelo, Panama. That completes the warm-up period. Judges, please call your first competitor.
Ha finalizado el tiempo de calentamiento. Damos inicio a la competencia.
Beginning on floor exercise in this second rotation for Panama, this is Valentina Rostella. Thank you. 25-year-old Valentina Brostella of Panama gets her team underway on floor exercise. A complicated final tumbling pass for her. Panama is currently in third position in this nascent team competition following its opening rotation on the balance beam. Some good work in this routine. Multiple twisting saltos in her second pass. As a child, Valentina had hip dysplasia, which is when the hip joint has not developed properly, and she actually began gymnastics at the urging of a doctor who thought that the sport would help combat it. And here she is today. Quite impressed on the landing of her double tuck, however. Floor exercise is like a 90-second sprint, and by the end of it, gymnasts are generally quite fatigued, even if they don't show it. Brostella has been to the World Championships twice, her last appearance coming in 2015. From Colombia, Angelica Mesa on vault. Yurchenko full. And she seems very pleased with that effort. The 29-year-old from Sogamoso. The score for Valentina Brostella in excess of 10 points. And now Lana Herrera on floor exercise. Lana Herrera, just 16 years old in her first Pan American Games. One of several gymnasts on this team who trains at No Limits Gymnastics in Panama City. And there is Carlos Gil, the national team coach, a man who was responsible for much of the success of Manrique Ladure of Cuba, a silver medalist in the all-around at the World Championships in 2015. He's moved from Cuba to Panama and begun coaching women's gymnastics, and Panama is clearly a team on the rise. There's such energy in her tumbling. She started off with a double layout and actually bounced out of bounds on her double tuck second pass. But I think she only put one foot out, so she'll receive a penalty of a single tenth of a point. This has been Herrera's senior debut season, and she has done great work so far. Iseth Valenzuela of Colombia takes to the vault. It's a very secure and well-flighted Yurchenko fall. Good entry, nice amplitude, plenty of time to get the twist around and spot the ground as she lands. For a hop back like that, she might lose in the neighborhood of 0.3 of a point. 12.733, the score for Valenzuela. Carla Navas of Panama. The 19-year-old all-around national champion of her nation. Carla Navas of Panama, a gymnast who won 3 silver medals at the Central American and Caribbean Games earlier this season. She is also the vault champion at the Pan American Championships in 2022. Earlier, we mentioned her gymnastics pedigree. Her grandfather actually represented Panama at the 1968 Olympics in weightlifting. And her mother, Veronica Boyd, was a national championship winning gymnast in Panama a couple decades ago. She really worked through this routine in a business-like way. Not giving away too much in execution deductions, solid tumbling, and compelling choreography. Over on the vault, Gina Escobar. That's a beautiful 1.5 twisting Yurchenko. And now on floor exercise, Hillary Heron of Panama. And this is a very big routine. been an extraordinary year for Hillary Heron of Panama, and it is not over yet. In fact, the results might just have begun at the Pan American Games. With that, Panama seems to have taken flight. This is a brilliant routine in so many ways, but we have to begin with the first tumbling pass, a Biles double layout with a half twist out, and then she follows up with a double layout second pass. At the World Championships earlier this month, she became the first gymnast ever to perform one of Simone Biles' elements that has been named for her at a World Championship, who was not Simone Biles herself. She said it was just a tremendous honor to be able to do that. And in addition, she has qualified herself as an individual all-around gymnast to the Paris Olympic Games. It's an extraordinary story, one befitting an extraordinary athlete who is just coming into her own. Score for Hillary Heron, somewhere in the neighborhood of 13 points. 12.966, actually, and that is the highest score that we have seen so far on floor exercise. This second rotation concludes. Mexico still in the lead after their performance on uneven bars. The graphic on your screen is a little bit out of date, but Colombia is in second place. Panama right now is in third. Their beginning on the balance beam was a bit rough, Team Panama's, but they have improved significantly on floor exercise. And that 12.966 from Hillary Heron will certainly help. There's one individual still to compete on the balance beam before gymnasts will rotate to their third rotation. Alexa Moreno did compete on the uneven bars. Her score there was 11.633. And that is accompanied by a 12.266 from Natalia Escalera. Meanwhile, Atsiri Sandoval on the uneven bars earned 13.333. And that is the second highest score that we have had on bars so far, the highest belonging to Caitlin Young of the USA, who had 13.633. And now to the balance beam. Here is Alexa Grande of El Salvador. Nice backhand spring layout step out combination right down the center of the beam. She hangs on to her side aerial. And good side Sami as well. This is the apparatus where she won the silver medal at last year's Bolivarian Games. Dismount, backhand spring through to layout with a full twist. Alexa Grande of El Salvador on balance beam. There's a lovely lightness to so much of her work on this apparatus. Very soft landings. Have another look at the beginning of her exercise. From the springboard, she does a forward roll mount. Here was the side aerial. The deduction for the wobble will be pretty minimal, maybe 1 or 2 tenths of a point. Same thing for that slight hop on landing. Alexa Grande competed at the World Championships in 2019, and her best finish there was on the balance beam. Oh, there just is an infectious quality to Panama, isn't there? 11.1 the score for Alexa Grande on the balance beam. And that will conclude rotation two.
Damos paso a la tercera rotación.
Team standings in the lead so far, Mexico with 77.964 points, followed by Colombia. They are trailing by about 5.5 points, and Panama behind them.
Trained incredibly hard for this moment. We kindly ask you to turn your mobiles to silent during the competition. We count on you for your cooperation.
Les recordamos utilizar sus cámaras o celulares con el flash desactivado. Estas luces podrían distraer y encarrilar a los competidores que han entrenado duramente para este momento. Les solicitamos que pongan sus teléfonos móviles en modo silencioso durante la competencia. Contamos con su colaboración.
Gymnasts, your warm-up begins now.
Damos inicio al tiempo de calentamiento.
A look at the start list for Mexico on balance beam. It will be Natalia Escalera leading off the team, Paulina Campos to follow, and then Cassandra Lustalot. Colombia will be on the uneven bars.
On balance beam,
where we will have the routines of Angelica Mesa, followed by Deira La Madrid, Gina Escobar, and Luisa Blanco.
Bolivia, Jamaica, El Salvador.
El suelo, grupo mixto, uno. Ecuador, Bolivia, Jamaica, y El Salvador.
Mexico going through the paces on balance beam.
That completes the warm-up period. Judges, please call your first competitor.
Ha finalizado el tiempo de calentamiento. Damos inicio a la competencia.
It's a nervous apparatus, the balance beam. Whether you are competing on it or whether it's your teammate. Escalera of Mexico on the balance beam. She saves her front aerial. And that will be a slight deduction. However, the important thing is that she saved herself from falling off, which would have been a point deduction. Steady back handspring layout step out combination. Lovely front pike as well. The switch leap with a half turn. The hips have to be completely rotated to be in line with the beam in order for the gymnast to get credit for that element. She has had to fight in some places to stay on, but there have been other moments of real confidence in this exercise. Double pike dismount. Natalia Escalera. They counted on the national champion to lead them off well, and she has done her job. Again, there were moments where she lost maybe 1 to 3 tenths of a point on those wobbles. However, it really counts for something not to fall. And this was maybe the highlight of the whole routine. Great height on her double pike dismount. Escalera, a gymnast who won gold with the Mexican team at the Central American and Caribbean Games earlier this year. And unfortunately for Colombia, they have had a fall from the gymnast now on the uneven bars. Mm-hmm. and she opts for just a simple tuck flyaway dismount. Hello from Natalia Escalera, fresh from doing her balance beam routine. In the first rotation, Escalera scored 13.166. That was her average for her two vaults. And only she and Atsiri Sandoval have competed two vaults so far. She was a world finalist on the apparatus in 2021. And she called that 2021 season a dream come true for her. .966 the score for Natalia Escalera, the first to compete for Mexico on the balance beam. And it appears that Paulina Campos has fallen on her mount and had to remount the beam. Good back handspring layout. Campos, 23 years old, highly experienced. She has been to four world championships. And she's really only been training quite seriously since 2018. She had a long spell of injury that affected her ability to do gymnastics at the highest level. But since then, she has been a key member of the national team. One and a half twisting dismount. Good landing. And from this view, you get a look at how narrow the balance beam really is. Commentators often hammer it in that, yes, it's only 4 inches wide, but until you stand up on a beam or maybe see it from that angle, it's hard to get a sense of what 4 inches really means. And it just reinforces how incredible it is, the things that gymnasts are able to do on balance beam. Paulina Campos. And now for Colombia on uneven bars, Gina Escobar. Smooth Ginger. And there's a Hindorf. Clear hip in to Kachev. Dismount, double tuck. 26-year-old Gina Escobar of Colombia. She works as a sports psychologist. Her job is to help young athletes of different sports, and she finds that her experience in gymnastics gives her insight into what other younger athletes are going through, and she says it's really made her more empathetic. She calls her work a beautiful challenge. 11.7, her score on the uneven bars. We head over to the balance beam and Cassandra Lustalot. Ambitious back handspring layout combination, the first that we've seen today. And she has great amplitude in her leaps and the jumps. Split jump done crosswise to the balance beam. That increases the difficulty of the element. Round off double pike. That amplitude on display once again. Cassandra Lustalot, the 23-year-old from Mexico, looking happy and relieved at the conclusion of that exercise. The before and after facial expressions are striking. The concentration that this takes is extraordinary. She had a small wobble, but really dealt with it, made sure it was no problem at all. Mexico has looked a little apprehensive on balance beam so far, but this is an exercise that they can be proud of. Yes. And now on the uneven bars for Colombia, Luisa Blanco. Maloney to Pac Salto to begin a very popular combination in international gymnastics right now. Beautiful toe stalder half to the high bar, too. And full twisting double tuck dismount. Let's call that a stick. A successful routine on the uneven bars from the Colombian national all-around champion, Luisa Blanco, the gymnast who has so recently begun representing them. And they are delighted to have her. 11.966, the score for Blanco on the uneven bars. One more to compete for Mexico on balance beam. The score for Cassandra Lustalot, 12.666. And here is Atziri Sandoval, the 27-year-old veteran from Guadalajara. And she puts her experience to good use early in the routine. Authoritative punch front somersault. Side aerial to back tuck combination. Risky because she doesn't touch the beam with her hands on either element. Dismount. What we saw there is potentially the fruit of experience. There was a big wobble early on, but she did not let it phase her. She fought and she stayed on. Punch front, one of the eight counting skills. And this was very nice indeed. Unusual dismount. The front layout with 1.5 twists, also called a Rudy. Atziri Sandoval missed the Pan American Games 4 years ago due to a ligament injury in one of her toes that actually required surgery. She had great results both on vault and on uneven bars at the World Championships in Belgium earlier this month. Those were her fifth World Championships. A look at how each team is faring as they wait for the announcement that the third rotation is at an end. 11.866 the score for Atziri Sandoval of Mexico. And here we have updated standings. Mexico leading the way with an excess of 114 points, followed by Colombia and Panama. This is, of course, just the start of the day. Teams coming include Argentina, Brazil, Canada, Chile, Puerto Rico, and the United States of America. A team with an extraordinary winning record at this event. As the teams rotate to their final rotation. A look inside this magnificent newly constructed arena. The rather soothing teal colors of the Santiago Pan American Games.
Gymnasts, your warm-up begins now.
In this final rotation, the mixed group will be on vault. Panama on uneven bars, Colombia on the balance beam, and Mexico on floor exercise. Mexico leading the way early on.
In this rotation, starting on vault, mixed group one, Bolivia, Jamaica, El Salvador, and Ecuador.
En esta rotación, el salto, grupo mixto uno, Bolivia, Jamaica, El Salvador.
The rotation order for Panama on uneven bars. Hillary Heron will lead them off, followed by Valentina Brostella. Lana Herrera will go in the third spot.
Elvira, Colombia.
And on floor exercise, Mexico.
Y el suelo, Mexico.
Gymnast, that completes your warm-up. Judges, please call your first competitor.
Ha finalizado el tiempo de calentamiento. Damos inicio a la competencia.
Beginning on the floor exercise for Mexico will be Paulina Campos. Paulina Campos of Mexico is the first to perform on floor exercise. Paulina Campos of Mexico leading off her team on floor exercise. The 23-year-old from San Luis Potosi. She's receiving warm congratulations from her coaching team, concluding a successful competition, her debut at the Pan American Games. very solid tumbling overall and quite engaging choreography. Well set to the music. We don't see too many headstands on floor. And she dresses it up. Campos is coached by her mom, Esmeralda, who is a gymnast herself. She says of the two of them, we always move forward together. Mexico began on vault, and on floor exercise, Paulina Campos leads off with an 11.833. The second gymnast to perform will be Cassandra Lustalot. She was so impressive with the amplitude of her skills on balance beam. Let's see if she can bring that to floor exercise. Cassandra Lustalot of Mexico, the 23-year-old, finishing her qualifying competition at these Pan American Games. It's a very fatiguing exercise with four difficult tumbling passes. The World Championships earlier this month, she got a lot of attention for it because it's a routine that has so many double salto skills. And her fall on her Arabian double front might have been due to trying to have a landing that was a little too perfect. And as a result, she didn't hang on quite as long to the tuck position as she could have and sat down. Moving over to the uneven bars, here is Panama's Hillary Heron. Shaposhnikova to immediate ginger. And the straddle Jaeger. double tech dismount. Hillary Heron of Panama dismounting from the uneven bars. A successful routine, though throughout there are small form errors. Every now and again, her legs separate on some of her swinging skills. The dismount, double tuck. She says that she's been really working to clean up her execution. And 11.733, her score for that exercise. Now on floor for Mexico, Natalia Escalera. Natalia Escalera of Mexico with a lovely routine through and through. The 21-year-old from Ensenada in northern Mexico. It's a massive aerospace center, and she really took off with her tumbling. One of her middle tumbling passes, front layout with a full twist and walks out of it through to double tuck and a very secure landing. On that pass that we just saw, she did land with both feet out of bounds, so she'll receive 0.3 of a point as a penalty. And now to Atziri Sandoval. Sandoval of Mexico, the 27-year-old from Guadalajara.
Yeah, cerramos el tiro.
Solid tumbling throughout this exercise. A double pike and then a double tuck. 12.